Hello, and welcome back to my channel. Today I am here in front of Neibolt, even though I don't know how much of it you can see, to do a video for you on how I do my Pennywise makeup when I cosplay him. Now, I like to do Pennywise a little bit extra, a little glam. We do like a little bit of a black, red, smoky eye, even though he doesn't really have that. You know, I just like to be a little extra because I'm sort of also like a gender bent version of Pennywise. And it's one of my favorite costumes to wear. It is, you know, as someone who loves makeup so much, it is such a weird thing to me that I've always picked costumes that don't really have a lot of crazy makeup. So being Pennywise is my chance to wear and do a ton of makeup with a costume. And it's also probably the one time when children run from me screaming, not just because I'm in a wheelchair. Yes, actually at Fan Expo last year, there was a small child who was actually genuinely afraid of me. Now, I've already started this video off with a little bit of a lie because I said I'm gonna do my makeup how I do it for Pennywise, but I want to block out my eyebrows, and I have never done that for Pennywise before, but I want to do it today and going forward. I spent all day yesterday practicing. This is just an Elmer's glue stick, and I'm just going to use it to push all of my hairs up, and then I'm going to use my ring finger to go around the outside edge to make sure that there's not glue all over my face, because that was something else I learned yesterday that you can't really have. And it took me about 3 layers of gluing and then powdering the glue down in order to get my eyebrows sufficiently covered. So I am gonna do that today as well. I might not, you know, include all 3 or 4 layers in the video just because that's really boring for you to watch me do this that many times. But just keep in mind, that's how I do it. The first couple of times I tried to block out my eyebrows, I failed epically. And I think that's because I just didn't do enough layers of glue and powder and glue and powder. So that would be my advice if you're someone who's new to the blocking out your eyebrows for whatever reason game. Don't be afraid to do 1,000 layers, especially if you're just using an Elmer's glue stick like this. It really does just wash off with water and some face wash. And I'm wearing my black Pennywise shirt and not my costume just for sort of this step, because when I powder this glue down, I get powder everywhere. After we're done the eyebrows, I will change into the costume. But see, that is me gluing them down, and then I just have to sit here and wait for what usually feels like 1,000 years. And then we powder, and then we glue, and then we powder, then we glue. The powder I'm gonna use today is actually just this 21 uses powder, because it's sort of like baby powder that you can use on your face. Like it says, you can use it to set makeup. And the reason I'm using this specifically is because it's white. So many other face powders have sort of like a tint to them because they're trying to look like a skin tone, whereas this is actually white. This is the whitest powder I own. And Pennywise obviously is a clown, so he's got quite a bit of white makeup on. So that's what I'm gonna use. I'm just gonna take some of that powder out. Eh, it's a little yellower, but whatever. It's the closest thing I have. Take a ton of it on a brush. Okay, so now that I have those all powdered down, I'm gonna do this again.
Six and a half hours later.
So what you're gonna wanna do after you have about 4 layers of glue and powder on your eyebrow is then take a really good sort of full coverage concealer. I'm using my Lancome long-lasting under-eye concealer. It's really good. It's like waterproof and really high coverage, and I like to pat it on and then also kind of use it to half smooth my eyebrow out. If you have color correctors, I would advise you use those underneath. This is the best I've ever looked. And then you're just gonna let that dry, and then once it dries, you change into the costume. Okay, costume is on. It took me about 1,000 years to get on. I can tell that quarantine has not been kind to me because it's very tight. Before I actually put the white all over my face, I am going to do my eye makeup. So what I do first is I take the white jumbo eye pencil, milk, that's what it's called, and I kind of go up to my eyebrow zone and from my crease. So I don't actually go onto my crease. I just kind of go up and around the eyeball. Anyway, I think, why are we doing this? We're doing this because I have a habit of getting makeup all over my face, and I would rather get black eyeshadow on my naked face than on my final white face paint. I'm just gonna powder that down a little bit. This powder isn't as white as I thought it was. So So now I'm going to use the HUDA Ruby Obsession. You saw that, right? I used the HUDA Ruby Obsessions palette, which now no longer has a mirror. I'm going to kind of build from lightest red to darkest red using only the mattes. So I need like a pretty fluffy brush first to go into the sort of peachy color, and that one will be big. Nice on the big peachy eye. Then we go one darker and focus it more. And then taking a smaller, skinnier brush, I want to use my Visanti brush. Where is it? There it is. This one, and I'm going to go with that deepest, juiciest red right there and just get that like right in the crease. Now, obviously, Pennywise, not only does he not really wear any eye makeup, but he definitely doesn't wear a red smoky eye. But that's one of my favorite things about cosplay, is you can do whatever you want. So now that that's on, I'm gonna take the Jumbo Eye Pencil, my trusty dusty Black Bean Jumbo Eye Pencil, and like really get it up in the waterline, lower waterline, you know, all over the eyelid. And then I'm gonna take a sort of flat brush and a matte black eyeshadow. I'm gonna use the matte black eyeshadow from the Sabrina palette, but it can be any matte black eyeshadow you want or you already own. Just don't leave it with the Jumbo Eye Pencil, like without setting it with an eyeshadow. That's all I ask. Because that's how you're gonna get creasing and it's gonna get all over your face and it's just not gonna go well for you. See, and that fallout underneath is why we do this before I put on my face makeup. Okay, and then what you're gonna wanna do is go back into the HUDA palette with that last brush I used and that last dark red shade and just kind of use that to buff out the crease. Not only will it make it redder, but it'll diffuse some of that black. And now you can make your arguments about if Pennywise would wear mascara or if he would not wear mascara. My Pennywise wears mascara. Not only does my Pennywise wear mascara, he wears falsies. But just like magnetic ones, because then they're easy to take off and I don't have to worry about wrecking them. I mean, if I was going to like a convention today, I might wear big fancy falsies, but something tells me that's not going to happen again for a while. Now that lashes are on, we can get on to the white face portion of this. So the white face paint that I use is this one. I bought it at a convention at a booth for like $5. The brand is Cheek FX. And this is their face and body art white color. And it says it cost me $13, but I just feel like that's not accurate. So there are two kind of ways that I've seen people apply makeup like this. They either spray this directly or they spray the applicator. I prefer to spray this directly. You can do with that information what you will. So you just spray it with water. And last year when I made my, oh, it's dripping onto the floor. Last year when I made my The Exorcist look, I took my green one of these and I sprayed it with a, like way too much water, and then I just poured the sort of greeny water excess out into a thing of liquid latex. So here's what we do. And if you have seen any of my recent videos where we apply cream makeup, you can already tell why I'm such an advocate for, even if it's just a, what some people might call a silly simple Halloween costume. Like, why make your life more difficult? Just get something like this. I'm a big believer in spending a little extra money if it means saving my sanity. All right, your moment of truth, guys. Over the eyebrows. And just for consistency's sake, like, this is the same brush that I used in the cream makeup that we did in a couple of my kit videos this year. So, like, you really can't blame me. I mean, you can, and you'd probably be right. Oh, starting to dry up. Needs a little more water. Now, I'm not going to go, like, all the way up into my hairline because I am going to be putting on my red wig. But the other nice thing about water-activated makeup is that it dries down. Now, I'm going to let this dry a little bit. It looks really silly in the viewfinder. And then I'll go in with a little bit more. So just a little bit more now that that's dried, just so that I get a really nice, thick, even coat. If you're wondering why I'm not bringing it down to my neck or to my chest, there is a collar piece for this costume. I'm just not wearing it yet, because why would I put on the collar piece when really all it would do right now is get makeup all over it? I think that's enough white. So we're just gonna let that dry a little bit, and then really we're almost done. We just do the nose, the things, and the mouth. So to do the rest of this, there are about a bajillion things you could do. I took out a couple of things here. You could obviously just use lipstick. I'm gonna wear this lipstick and I might use it as the things too. This is the Maybelline SuperStay Matte Ink in the shade Dancer. It's this really nice sort of bright red. I also have this Rimmel eyeliner that I'm probably gonna use for the nose especially. And then of course there's always the option of more water activated makeup. So I had this Snazaroo kit that we reviewed last year on my channel, and it has a very nice red shade in it, so you could always use that as the lines on Pennywise's face as well. I haven't really decided which way I want to go. I am gonna go into this Sabrina palette and take a little bit of like this grayish color that I always use and just cheat a little bit contour my nose a little bit. And then I'm gonna take the Rimmel eyeliner, like I said, and we're gonna use this for the nose. Now sometimes I draw the nose sort of like a cat nose, and then sometimes I do the whole little end, which is more accurate to what Pennywise's nose looks like. So that's what I'm gonna do. Now someone smarter than me would outline this first in something that's easy to erase, like a light eyebrow pencil. I like to live on the edge. So that's sort of the nose shape that I want. And then as far as the lines go, this is not at full opacity, so we'll just use it. This is definitely getting kind of old. And really, as long as you follow that sort of general shape. So that sort of matches. So I'm gonna do it with this, even though I'm never gonna be able to get this off. We're gonna fill in this. It's so funny, it's been years since I've had my nose pierced, but like, the scar is still so there that makeup, like face paint like this, just settles right into it. Something I didn't even think of doing until right now is dipping a skinnier brush into the liquid lipstick. We're just gonna clean up this side over here where I was a little bit messy with a cotton swab. Now my lips, and I'm gonna really exaggerate the bottom lip. So with the wig on and the neck piece, this is the final version of how I do my Pennywise makeup look. I think it's so much fun. This is one of my favorite costumes that I do. And I recently bought the teeth, and you had to like fit them to your gums, like with this gel stuff, similar to how we did the vampire teeth last year, and they still don't fit. So I can't really wear them, but I can wear them for like a second. This is so cute. This is the best I've ever looked. It's frustrating because they are fit to my teeth, but they just don't want to stay in. I did my best. Anyway, I hope you like this video. Make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you have not subscribed already. Don't forget, if you do anything fun or spoopy this Halloween season, you tag me on Instagram so I can see what you're up to. My Instagram handle is at Abby Lane Green, ABBYLANEGREEN. I just want to see how you're celebrating Halloween this year, because it looks a little bit different, but that doesn't mean that we can't still have fun and we can't still do silly things like dress up like this on a Monday afternoon and watch scary movies and eat snacks. And I just want to see what you're doing to help keep the spoopy spirit alive, because I feel like if any year needed Halloween, it's this year. Anyway, thank you again for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!